Hey, welcome and good day. I'm here in my office in the Lensman Project Gallery, and today we're going to shift gears a little bit from sports and some of the things we've been talking about with the workshops, and we're going to talk about a project that I've been working on. I love blues music, and I have for a really long time. I love to listen to people like Paul Butterfield and Hound Dog Taylor and the House Rockers and Robert Johnson and a lot of Pine Top Perkins and a lot of these old timers, and I always wanted to get out and start photographing some of these people. And so for the most part, when I was at Sports Illustrated, I just didn't have the time. So at a certain point, when I started to step back from so many assignments from Sports Illustrated, I decided that I was just gonna get out there and do this. As I moved along on this, I always had a book project in the back of my mind. And so I shot everything originally in color, but I transferred it all to black and white because for me, black and white and the blues, it just went together. Kind of the way I did it, it was no structure to it. I just sort of like rolled with wherever I felt I could get in contact with somebody. And so I just kept picking up little tidbits of this guy lives over in Bessemer, Alabama, or this juke joint is down there in Marigold, Mississippi. You really need to go and photograph that. Most of these guys are really obscure. They're not household names. So they're not the B.B. Kings, they're not the Eric Claptons, they're not the Stevie Ray Vaughans. They're just a lot of guys that really love music. So I went over to Memphis and I photographed some people over there, and then that led to another person told me about this person who told me about that person who led me to finally to Clarksdale, Mississippi. And Clarksdale is a legendary blues town. It's the crossroads. It's where supposedly Robert Johnson traded his soul to the devil at the crossroads to be a great guitar player and great singer. You know, I photographed B.B. King, but I also photographed a lot of obscure guys like Ironing Board Sam, Blues Mother Cone, you know, I mean, people like that, that just, they get out there, T Model Ford, guys that were just out there just to make music. And one of the things that I always did was, if they had some CDs, I bought it from them, or I always tried to bring them some booze. And we're gonna show you a few images from the book project, American Blues, and it's gonna be narrated by my good friend, Gil Gann, Blues Man. Gil is the real deal. He lives, eats, sleeps blues. So I hope you enjoy it.
The blues. We know what it sounds like. It's original and groovy and soulful with deep, sometimes tragic roots. Say the blues, and you don't just hear the strumming of slow, funky guitars and the humming of low, gravelly voices. Right away, the sound of the word blues evokes images. Most of them in black and white and sepia tone, or partially in shadow and shade. You see faces full of joy, full of pain, full of life. You see players at Gipps in Bessemer, Alabama, and Printer's Alley in Nashville, Tennessee, and all around Clarksdale, Mississippi, and Helena, Arkansas, and Memphis, and Chicago, and New Orleans. You see players from B.B. King and Buddy Guy to Watermelon Slim and Pat Mother Blues Cohen in the humble juke joints and clubs that may or may not have made them famous. You see players in their homes from Kingfish Ingram and Victor Wainwright to Mickey Rogers and Washboard Joe. surviving, striving, and sometimes even thriving. These images, together, they tell a powerful story. Perfectly complement the songs and the sound of the most American of art forms, the blues.
I hope you enjoyed these images that you just viewed. Shortly after I photographed B.B. King in Indianola, Mississippi, B.B. King passed away. I decided to go over to Memphis for the funeral, and it was an absolutely extraordinary event. The people were just lined on both sides of the street. Bobby Blue Bland's son carried Lucille down the main street, just with the throngs of people behind it. So here's a look at a little final tribute to B.B. King. If you enjoyed this video, click the subscribe button down in the lower right-hand corner and also click the bell, and you'll be notified of all of our upcoming Lensman Project videos.